Good morning to everyone. On behalf of the Thillaisthanam Foundation, I'd like to welcome all of you to this event today. Thank you so much for coming to this program. First off, I'd like to start by thanking our hosts, Priyaka and Sri Manohar. Thank you so much for hosting this concert here at your lovely residence. I think it was their idea that we could have concerts in many houses, and it would really enrich in our experiences to do it at various venues. So thank you so much for that. And for those of you who don't know them, they are probably two of the most incredible people I've had the good fortune of knowing. So they are amazing, amazing people. And so thank you so much for hosting this event here. A word about the Thillaisthanam Foundation itself. A word about the foundation itself. The Thillaisthanam Foundation was started by us in honor of Thillaisthanam Ramayangar, who was one of the most prominent disciples of the great Carnatic music composer Sadhguru Thyagarajar. He learned directly from him in the Agraharam village of Thillaisthanam near Thiruvayar. And we, being his descendants, thought that it would be nice to honor his legacy. And so we have started this foundation in his honor. The goal of the foundation is to conduct such Carnatic music events in chamber-like settings to bring both connoisseurs as well as newcomers to Carnatic music all together. And so that we can all collectively experience the joy of Carnatic music. And so we are delighted today that we have four amazing artists joining us today to present a performance. We are really thrilled to have with us four outstanding artists join us today to present a Carnatic concert for us. Sri Mysore A. Chandan Kumar playing the flute. Srimati Sindhu Suchethan playing the violin. Sri H S Sudhindra playing the Mridangam. And Sri Giridhar Udupa playing the Ghatam. I'd like to begin by just saying a few words about the artists. Sri Mysore A. Chandan Kumar hails from an incredibly illustrious great musical lineage. He is the great-grandson of legendary violinist Sangeeta Kalanidhi, Sangeeta Ratna late Mysore T. Chaudhaya. People who are familiar with Bangalore need no introduction. The great Chaudhaya Hall, which is incredibly shaped in the form of a violin, dedicated to in his memory by the government of Karnataka. Sri Chandan Kumar learned from M. Gopalakrishna, and we share a common guru as well, P.S. Narayan Swami sir. So he learned from him as well. Chandan Kumar ji was directly promoted to A grade from B grade of the All India Radio in 1999. He has performed several times for Akashvani, Sangeet Sammelan, as well as Doordarshan, performed many times on television, on BBC, Munich Radio, performed at all the biggest venues across the world, Madras Music Academy, Sangeet Natak Academy, Shanmuganand Sabha, India Habitat Center in Delhi, and he has toured several countries, the United States, United Kingdom, Malaysia, and so on. Chandan Kumarji was the first Carnatic musician to perform a pure Carnatic music concert at the Darbar South Asian Festival in the UK. He was invited by the ICCR to perform at the Carvalino International Festival in Mexico. His play is characterized by powerful blow, beautiful melody, and lots of creativity. He is really well known for his Jugalbandi presentations as well. Not only that, he has held teaching appointments and taught at universities, and he has brought up many, many students, some of whom are in attendance here today as well. So we are really, really, really thrilled that Chandan Kumar ji could join us, and we thank you so much for Srimati Sindhu Suchethan also hails from a rich musical lineage. She's the granddaughter of violinist A.V. Venkatnarayana, who was a disciple of Sangeetha Kalanidhi T. Chaudhaya. She trained under Sri H.K. Narasimhamurthy and Srimati H.N. Rajalakshmi. She has also been mentored by Vidushi Pushpa Srinivasan and Sri T.K. Srinivasan, as well as the violinist Sri H.N. Bhaskar. She has performed with practically all the leading artists in the field, really a popular violinist playing, incredibly busy artist, so really hard to get her, so very happy that she could join us. She also performs violin duet concerts with her sister, H.N. Smita, who's also an accomplished violinist. She's an A-grade artist of the All India Radio. She's a winner of the Yuva Purandara Award from Indranagar Sangeet Sabha, and she's received the Best Concert Award from the Madras Music Academy as well. Her playing is really known for bhava and really chaste music. So we are really, really happy that Srimati Sindhu Suchethan could join us today. Thank you so much. I have never had the fortune of meeting Chandan Kumar ji and Sindhu Suchethan ji before today, but the next two artists, Sudhindra sir and Giridhar Udupa, I have known for nearly 30 years, ever since the first time I came to Bangalore to perform as well. So I really, really am so happy for their support and friendship all through these years. Sri H S Sudhindra sir's gurus are the great Mridangam Vidwans, Sri M. Vasudev Rao and Sri Srimushnam Raja Rao sir. Sudhindra sir has been performing right from the age of 13, right? And he's accompanied almost all the leading musicians in India, abroad, everywhere. There's not a stage where he's not performed. He's an A-top AIR artist, performs regularly in the December Music Festival in Chennai as well, of course, all the venues here in Bangalore as well. Played several times on the national programs of music in the Doordarshan, in All India Radio, Akashvani Sangeet Sammelan as well. Several lecture demonstration he conducts through his organization, Suswaralaya Foundation. Just so many concerts and workshops and lecture demonstrations and so on. Incredible service to the entire Bangalore community. We are really, really fortunate that he is with us here today. Several titles to his name, Laya Kala. Laya Kala Pratibhamani and Gana Kalashri. So we are really, really happy that H. S. Sudhindra sir could be here with us today. Last but not the least in any way, Sri Giridhar Udupa. Sri Giridhar Udupa is really synonymous with the Ghatam. Right? Today is Ghatam Giridhar Udupa. One of the most loved Ghatam artists today. Really, everyone loves to have Giridhar performing. He's been performing for 3 decades in more than 50 countries and is really a pioneer of the art. He first learnt under his father, Vidwan Ulur Nagendra Udupa, and then under Srimati Sukanya Ram Gopalji and Sri V. Suresh. He is the founder and director of the Udupa Foundation. And the Udupa Foundation, again, is a wonderful foundation that promotes Carnatic music in various places where Carnatic music is normally not heard, various government schools, old age homes, and so on and so forth. The foundation does an incredible job of promoting music over there. And they conduct a festival as well where all the biggest Carnatic musicians and Hindustani musicians and world musicians literally come and perform at the festival. Giri is the brand ambassador for AKG microphones and the youngest to get the A-top gradation from AIR and Doordarshan. He's really performed with everybody in the field. Sri R.K. Srikantanji, M. Balamurli Krishnaji, T.N. Krishnan sir, Umayalpuram K. Sivaraman sir, Ramani sir, M.S. Gopalakrishnan sir, everybody. Several Hindustani artists as well, Pandit Shivakumar Sharmaji, Pandit Hari Prasad Chaurasiaji, Ustad Amjad Ali Khanji, Pandit Jasraj, Pandit Biju Maharaj, Ustad Zakir Hussain, list is endless. He has performed at the United Nations, Carnegie Hall, Sydney Opera House, all the biggest venues. He has received the Gana Kalashri Award, the Ustad Bismillah Khan Yuva Purskar from Sangeet Natak Academy Award and Best Upapakavadyam Award from Madras Music Academy, among many other awards. So Giri, we are delighted that you could join us today. Before handing over the stage to the artists, I'd like to just make a few housekeeping announcements. If you'd like to use the restroom, there are restrooms on that side of outside the house. Please feel free to use them if you need it. I think water has been placed at several places in case you want to, outside as well as indoors. If you'd like to, and if you feel like going up and listening to the concert, you'll be able to hear the concert over there also. So you can feel free to do that as well. And finally, last but not least, we can just a reminder to turn off our cell phones. We have wonderful Sampat Kumarji, who's recording the video for us today, and Sri Vignesh over here providing outstanding quality sound, so we can really lose ourselves and just immerse ourselves in the music. So thank you very much to all of you for coming here, and over to the artists for the performance.
Thank you. This was the Varna, the Raja Abhogi. Next composition would be Mahaganapati. The next composition would be Mahaganapati, the Raga Naka, set to Ekatalam, composed by Sri Muthuswami Dikshita. Thank you.
Thank you.
This was Ganamurthi, the raga Ganamurthi. The third Melakatha raga among the 72, set to Aditalam, composed by Sri Thyagaraja Swami.
present a composition of the Tyagaraja Swami, Durmarga Charadhamulanu, Raga Ranjani Settu Rupakatharam. Thank you. as you all know, this was Raghuvamsha Sudha. I just gave it a try doing some mathematics in the swaram part. Carnatic music basically has lots of mathematics, and I applied the formula of the static and dynamics, keeping one swara as constant and changing rest of the swaras. I just gave it a try and somehow it came beautifully. So we had played a lot, keeping just myself and Sudhindra sir and Giri in this concert. I thought that will be a novel thing for you because you heard Raghuvamsha in a different format. Just wanted to show all the instrument possibilities also, so I just gave it a try. Now we'll move on to the main composition of this concert. If you can presume which raga, it would be fine. I don't mind announcing it now, but let me know.
How you wish.
I would rather prefer to play and then ask you which raga is there.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'll play a flash of thanams in 2-3 ragas and I'll just show the, as you all heard, Ganamurtha and all the text I played is completely the vocal style. There are few instrumental possibilities which can be only done on instruments. It's not that vocal has many options, but likewise instruments also has many options. So I'll just, I'm not going to do that in detail since I am running out of time. Just we'll do a flash of thanams and 2-3 ragams and I'll go to the main point.
Thank you.
one of the signature pieces of Sri Tyagaraja Swami, Inta Saukhya Mani, that's Raga Hindustani Kapi, set to Aditadam. That will be followed by a very grand Taniyavartanam by the Maestro.
Thank you. Thank you.
This composition doesn't need any introduction. Adai Payade of Uthukadu Kavirayar in Kannada Ragam Sattu Adithalam. Nishan told me to have an interactive session. If anyone from the Rasikas would love to ask anything, if we know about that, would love to explain that to you, and you know, otherwise it's up to you.
Yes, sir.
The raga, main raga I played was that same raga. I will play one composition and then later move on to, because it's... Anyone, please feel free to ask if you want to ask something about whatever we played.
You can ask any of the artists. We thought it would be nice to, in our events, have an informal question answer. People, if you have any questions about flute playing techniques or violin playing techniques or how they go about their lives, everything, right? As an artist, I'm very curious about how other artists deal with various things. So I'm always seeking for like what people are doing. So yeah, wonderful.
Why do generally all flautists, you know, they prefer to play kapi in concerts, one, uh-huh. And Panchama Varga Ragas?
I don't know about Panchama Varga Ragas. Panchama Varga Ragas is very, very difficult to play on flute.
But why do they generally, that's what we have...
Yeah, Indolam is generally played because it's more popular and people have heard it, and it has been established in the minds and souls. Maybe so that if you play Amsanandi and ragas like Ranjani, those are very difficult to play on violin and flute both. It's very risky, it's double side sword walking, so it's very difficult, but we gave it a try because Nishan told me to have a balance, don't play very scholarly, neither like Kalyana Kacheri, so I had a balance that, and I'm sure that all the audience are like catered. I tried my best. Yeah. Yes. Yes.
Raghuvamsa Sudha,
yes.
You elaborated one swara, right?
Mm-hmm.
That particular part I'm not able to really follow. What is exactly
which
your experiment
part,
is?
Because I played many parts, if you could tell me which.
No, no, I just want to know what is the kind of...
Actually what I did is like the Chitraswaram Vichar can be done in many permutations and combinations. With my limited knowledge, I try to do some permutation and combination, which is very risky and which sounds great when played on instruments, especially on flute or violin. So I thought that would impress the audience, and I chose that.
No, that was good, really. So I just wanted to have that.
Yeah. Nice that you asked us. It motivated us to do that next time in our concert. Thank
no,
you.
No, no. Actually, it was really very good. Thank you.
Thank you.
conclude, I would like to express my deepest gratitude for the Thillaisthanam Foundation. With special thanks to my dear colleague, Vidwan Shri Nishan Chandran. It's very special when an artist hosts a concert of other artists, and we all live because of all those great Bhagavatas who fed us and who have been feeding us all the time. To tribute them is always a blessing for all of us, and it's a very, very special day and such a beautiful morning today. And I thank the host, Mrs. Priya and Sri Manoharji, for hosting this beautiful ambience. And it's very hard to find the elite connoisseurs nowadays, and we are so blessed that we are connected with this foundation. And last but not the least, I would like to express my sincere thanks to my fellow musicians, without whom I wouldn't have taken the concert to this elevation. Thanks to my dear sister Sindhu, Vidwan Shri H S Sudhindra, and Vidwan Shri Giridhar Udupa. And a big round of applause to all of you for motivating us. Thank you. I will conclude this recital with a Thillana. As a request, Sri Lalgudi Jayaraman sir, because he also belongs to Thyagaraja tradition, so Revati Ragathillanam in Mishra Chapatalam.
First off, we'd really like to thank Chandan Kumarji, Sindhu Suchethan, Sudhindra sir, and Ghatam Giridhar Udupa. Thank you so much for a wonderful, wonderful performance. It really, I think, really made our day to be in this environment over here and listen to all of you perform. Chandanana, you copy, but such creativity. It was so wonderful to see such new dimensions of copy, and just wonderful to see Sindhu just feed off that and play beautifully. I mean, as a violinist, I also know sometimes you just are lost and engrossed in what the artist is playing, and then what do you play? But Sindhu also just portrayed a beautiful new dimension of copy as well. Both of you just feeding off your creativity, just amazing. And as rightly you said, those ragams are not easy to play, just a little bit, because I play the violin, I can speak about the technicalities in the violin. So the panchamam is not there, and one of the strings that is, two of the strings in the violin are tuned to the panchamam. So when you're bowing, you absolutely cannot play the open string for two of the strings, right? And to make matters harder for a pratimadhimam ragam like Ranjani or Hamsanandi, the pratimadhimam is up, quite a bit up on the sa string, and then you need to go down for the daivadam on the pa string. And so if you need to play something like Mada, Mada, good luck with that. So it takes a lot of... It's all the half notes on the flute. So it's incredibly difficult to play these ragams. I mean, it's not easy. It comes from years of practice. I mean, there's, of course, the genes and everything that's... I mean, the talent is there, but just years of dedication to the art. I think that is something that we really must appreciate in all these... I mean, all of you. I mean, and Sudhindra sir and Giri... Just, I mean, it's not just about the Tani Avartanam, it's just playing for the song, just your, both of you, whenever you play, it is literally the song, and the creativity of the melody is just coming out through your rhythm. Whatever both Chandanana and Sindhu are playing, all of that is just coming and speaking through the Mridangam and the Ghatam. Just amazing to see you just pick up on whatever they are doing and play that as well. Just phenomenal, both of you. And of course, the Tani Avartanam, I don't need to say anything. Exceptional, exceptional. And one thing with Sudhindra sir, I'm always... I know that whenever he plays a Tani Avartanam, he's always thinking through how can I tie it to all the patterns in the song and play an appropriate korve. And every time he just amazes me with something amazing. I'm just always so thrilled to see what, and eagerly looking forward to whatever he's playing. And Giri as well, you pick up everything that someone plays and just immediately just play it with your own variations. It's not just pick up and play it. It's play it, but put your own variation on it and play it again. It amazes me. Just, I mean, picking up and playing it is already hard, right? Because not just for some of you, I mean, this, none of this is practiced, right? None of this is rehearsed. Everything is on the spot. And just picking up and playing something on the spot is hard, but picking up something creative and then playing it with your own creativity in it, that requires another level of playing. So I really want to thank all of you for providing such a wonderful morning for us. Yes, wonderful. Thank you so much for Srivatsan for really keeping the talam phenomenally well and helping everybody out through the concert. I'd like to just thank our hosts one more time. Shri Manohar and Srimati Priyaka, for I think the environment over here just enriched the concert so much more. It's just wonderful to sit in this beautiful house and listen to music. We really, really enjoyed it. So thank you very much for that. I'd like to call upon them to present the artists with a small token of appreciation. So, Chandan Kumar. We'd also like to thank our dear friend Prabha, who's not here with us today, for the beautiful paintings that she's made. We try to get paintings made for the concert, so you'll notice that there are
special flute for me and violin. Thank you.
Right, so that is, we owe all our designs to Varsha over here, who's in the audience, who designed all the Angavastrams, and the logo as well, and so on. So thank you for that as well.
Thank you so much for coming here. It's been our privilege to host such wonderful audience here. Thank you, Thillaisthanam Foundation, for giving us this opportunity. When we get a new home, you do this Ganapati homam and invite lots of people. Here, I think it's a musical homam, and thank you for all coming here. You sanctified the house for us. Thank you so much. Please join us for lunch, and really appreciate all of you coming. Thank you so much, so much, so much.